This is the most asked question I ever had in my entire life. During my gaming career, I was asked different kind of questions. What is my age, weight, marriage, and so on. But this question completely broke all the records. According to my chatbot, this question was asked more than 4,000 times for the past 3 years. What is my mouse? And what is my sensitivity? I realize it's a really important question, not only for the new gamers, but also for the professional players. Since a lot of them are still testing different kind of DPIs and in-game settings for the better results. And that's why I finally decided to make this video and tell you everything what I know and why I use certain mouse and sensitivity. A lot about finding the certain mouse and sensitivity is down for the personal preference, but not all of it. There are some certain rules that you can follow to figure out which matches you better. First of all, let's start with the mouse, the most important gaming tool. Of course, there is no mouses which gonna make you instantly a pro player with 50% of headshot rate. It's not gonna happen. But if you already are a decent player with the decent skills, good mouse is must be. The question is how to find your perfect mouse. Size, shape, weight, sensor technology, and settings. The size is the most important thing for me. I like smaller mouse sizes for my grip because my palm is really small. That's why I use Logitech G Pro Wired mouse. It fits perfectly my claw grip style, where I have a total control over my mouse compared to the bigger models. It's really hard to be precise with a huge mouse. I can't feel or predict my aim at all. So if you have a small palm, Logitech G Pro Wired mouse would be a good option for you. But if you have a small or medium palm, Logitech G Pro Wireless option would be even better, since it's slightly bigger and has no wires. And both of these models has a perfect minimalistic shape. This is exactly what you need. Because all these transformer mices, despite their impressive appearance, they're uncomfortable to use. And don't forget about the weight. The less weight is always better, at least for me. You'll feel your aim on an absolutely different level. So that's why Logitech G recently did release their new Logitech G Pro Wireless Super Light mouse version. So they basically removed RGB logo and right side buttons. And now this mouse weighs only 61 grams with the wireless technology compared to the 82 grams. They also redesigned mouse skates, which is a great change. It's bigger and feels better. So far, this is one of the most expensive mouses, and there is a reason why. Third, and the most important criteria, is the sensor and technology of the mouse. And here comes the hero, high efficiency rating optical sensor. Right now, this is the best sensor on the gaming market. I have been using it for 2 years, and I never had issues at all. It is very precise sensor, and it has automatic lowest lift of distance 1.2 millimeters. It means it stops recording your movement at the lowest position when you lift your mouse. Also, Hero sensor has a flash memory. So if Logitech G Pro improves core algorithm for the better performance, you don't need to buy a new mouse. You just need to update your firmware. Also, Logitech provides the best wireless speed for the gaming accessories. There is no difference in latency between wired and wireless mouse. This has been proven by a lot of tech reviews. So if you have a chance, definitely grab the wireless version of the mouse. I'm still personally using the wired version just because I'm used to the size. But for my stream PC, I'm using the wireless one. Next important thing is settings. You will definitely have to find your own DPI. In my case, Logitech G Pro provides from 100 to 25,000 DPI, but I had mouses from different brands which offered only 300, 500 and 900 DPI, which is awful. I'm currently using 400 DPI and it's totally enough for me. I feel really comfortable and my aim feels way better on the lower DPI settings. Usually professional players are playing on 400 or 800 DPI, but there is also some players who are playing on 1600 DPI and they are showing insanely good results in the video games. I personally wouldn't suggest you to go higher than 1600 DPI unless you're playing on a huge monitor. And one more important thing, when you switch between two different mouses at the same DPI settings, it doesn't mean that you're gonna have the same sensitivity. I know it sounds weird, but I realized that all mouses has a different sensitivity at the same DPI settings. As you see on the monitor, that one mouse has less sensitivity than the other, even though they have the same sensor. The answer might be because the distance between sensor and your mouse pad is different, and that's why it slightly affects your general sensitivity at the same settings. I've heard that if you have two sensors from different brands, this difference can be even worse. So keep in mind, if you are changing your mouse, get ready to deal with the different sensitivity. And the last mouse setting is the polling rate. You can easily change your Logitech G Pro polling rate in the G Hub software, and it's really comfy. -500 Hz, and I think is the best choice for any gamer. I never felt the difference between 500 and 1000 Hz, but I definitely do not suggest you to use 125 Hz. Okay, so now let's move forward. How do you find your perfect sensitivity? Before you're gonna tweak your in-game settings, make sure to go to the control panel and disable your mouse acceleration settings. Go to the mouse properties and turn off enhanced pointer precision. Now, you're good to go. I was trying a lot of different kind of sensitivity settings from different pro players, but it always felt for me that something is missing there. So when you have chosen your perfect DPI, in my case it's 400, you should measure your centimeters per 360. So in my case, I'm using a huge mouse pad. So I measured the distance between keyboard and the edge of the mouse pad, and I found out that my perfect in-game sensitivity is 51. But for my scope settings, it's different. My scope sensitivity is 43 for all scopes. Since then, I haven't changed any settings, and I use them in all FPS games. For example, if I want to transfer my PUBG sense to Warzone, I'm just using sense calculator, which works perfectly. And when I switch between games, I always feel the same sense, and that's amazing. You can do that with CSGO or any other game. Just don't forget about your DPI, resolution, and FOV settings for a precise calculation. And that's it. I found the settings almost 3 years ago, and I haven't changed them at all, because I have already over 5,000 hours with them, and I have made insane outplays and headshots.
Adios!
Ooh.
Ooh.
It takes time to find your perfect mouse and then find your perfect sensitivity. And I see it every day because people come to my stream and ask these questions all over again. From the other side, it's really interesting to know your sensitivity settings. We all are different. Maybe some of you is using 3000 or 5000 DPI. I don't know. Share in the comments what kind of sensitivity do you use and why. And I'm gonna choose one winner who is gonna win the best pro gaming mouse ever. Don't forget to put that bell button, put the thumbs up, and I see you next time.